Hi there, today I'm going to show you some quick tricks for displaying text vertically in Unity. Official vertical support is unfortunately quite rare in many programs nowadays, so there's no real option here in the standard TextMeshPro, but there are some tricks that you can do. The thing most people try is just reducing the width until you get it perfectly straight. Now you'll see there's some vertical text here. Unfortunately, as you can see, it's kind of awkward to work with. First things first, automatic font size won't work. You'll have to manually put it up as high as you want. Spaces also don't really correlate to spaces. If you want to have a space, you'd have to do it with some enter. But then there's no way to have them kind of next to each other. The only option would be to duplicate the text and offset it a bit, which is a bit awkward. Because then here you have to remove this paragraph, and in the first one you'll have to remove this one. Now the trick I'm going to show is a quite simple one. Basically, TextMeshPro has a bunch of special tags, and we're going to be using one of them, the rotate tag. The idea is if we add a rotate tag at the beginning, and give it an angle of like 90 degrees, you'll see all the text gets rotated. Then all we have to do is just put in the reverse rotation in the z-axis, and now we have vertical text. Now, as you can see, the spacing is a bit awkward. Now, we could individually go to each letter and vertically offset it a bit, but this is a lot of work, and usually the easier solution is just to find a font where it works better. If we try out this font, for example, you can see it's centered much better. Okay, so first of all, you can see that with auto size enabled, the font size adjusts accordingly to the text box, which is much nicer for positioning stuff. Also, spaces correlate to spaces and paragraphs to paragraphs, although they will be reversed in position. Now, of course, there's probably still some per font things you want to do. Changing the spacing between each character usually helps a lot because most fonts weren't designed to be displayed vertically. And then any final things we can usually just adjust ourselves a bit. Now, some things will work better than others. If we put some numbers here, for example, you can see they display quite well. Also, the kanji of some Asian languages will work quite well. Unfortunately, it's our own Latin alphabet which looks very wonky, since the letters don't have the same distance between them. You can see this if we unrotate the text here. The spacing between the characters varies a lot. Unfortunately, the easiest solution is often just to find a font where it does work, because unless you have experience making fonts, you would have to change the distance between each letter combination. Now, some fonts will obviously be better than others, for example, monospace fonts, but another trick is just to write in all caps. Here you can see it's a lot more centered. There is no automatic solution either, since there is no algorithm that can find the optimal space between letters. This is a problem known as generalized kerning, and it is unfortunately undecidable. But finding a font that displays in all caps will usually help in this regard. As a quick refresher, you can just download a font, open it, and drag in the folder. And if we go in here to Windows, TextMeshPro Font Asset Creator, we can drag in the font, click Generate, and hit Save. And then we've got a TextMeshPro font that we can simply drag in. Now, another fun thing you can do is rotate the text just a bit and put the inverse in the rotate tag. And suddenly you've got some diagonal text, which can also look interesting. And you can, of course, try this with any arbitrary angle. Okay, there's one more tag I'd like to show you. If you noticed earlier, I mentioned that the order of the paragraphs is inverted, but luckily we can do a little hack. There's the line height tag, and if we give this a value of 100%, you'll see it doesn't affect anything, but if we put a minus in front, it inverts it. And yeah, this tag is probably one you'll want to have by default as well. Now, all these tags are starting to take up a lot of space, so what we can do is add a text style here like these. To do this, we can just go to TextMeshPro, Resources, Style Sheets, and then here in this default style sheet asset, you'll see all the things we previously saw. All we have to do here is just click on the plus, and then we can make our own. We can call it, for example, vertical, and paste the tags from earlier. Also, optionally, you can add the closing tags, but it doesn't really make a difference. And now all we have to do is just go to our text objects, and if we select vertical here, they'll have all the things we need. There's also a tag for this character spacing here. We can just add a C space tag and set it to some value. An EM is the font unit. as opposed to other units like just pixels. And then if we go back and reset the character spacing here, you'll see we can now finally adjust whatever we want. Okay, but yeah, those were my quick tips for vertical text. I hope you guys enjoyed it.
I'll see you next time.